You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
My name is Marcus Curtis, and I am the founder of the American Molossus. The American Molossus is a brand new breed. It's a breed that, a vision of mine and a direction that I decided to go. And just to let everybody know out there, what I'm doing is nothing new. Basically, throughout history, man has made the breeds. The original breeds were a Molosser type, which I'm trying to recreate, and the wolves and stuff like that. So I pretty much, I'm recreating something that existed around 5,000 years BC. The real inspiration of the American Molossus came from doing some studying on the current breed, Neapolitan Mastiffs. I've actually did a lot of research, and a lot of those descendants came from this original Molossus that was 5,000 years ago, and there are statues and paintings of these great massive dogs that had cropped ears, cropped tail, looked like sheer bears. I get so excited about recreating what once was that I literally can't sleep about it. Anybody that knows me knows that I get so excited and so passionate about it that I literally get goosebumps, because it's something that it's like looking back into ancient time. So the process is something that's been, it's an evolution, using specific dogs that have key characteristics, temperament and look, because you're creating something that actually doesn't exist. So what I basically do is I have a standard written of what I've envisioned based on statues of the ancient Molossus. I have drawings and sketches. So I'm taking dogs that have those looks, incorporating them together to get that type of look, the sheer mass, the volume of body, the angulation, top line, the squareness of the head, pendulous lips and dewlap like some dogs, but wider chests like others, and also the temperament, because these dogs were literally fearless. They would not wander. They weren't a high drive dog. They were a dog that would stick by their usually women and children at that nomadic time, one that would fight off humans and also could fight off bears, lions, whatever could have been. And that dog has to be massive, strong, high tolerance to pain, loose skin in case it got bit. So a lot of thought went into this, and there's going to be a lot of work going into creating this breed. But I guarantee you, when you see this dog, own this dog, you'll see all the hard work paid off. The groundwork was done for many, many years of other breeders in other breeds and my own breed. I've been working towards this vision in the breed I'm in for, I'd say, the last 10 years. The Neapolitan Mastiffs have a few key elements that I think are not what the original Molossus dog of ancient Mesopotamia had. They don't have, from an aesthetic standpoint, they don't have the body mass nor the size of the types of dogs that would have been around as depicted in paintings and in statues and stuff of those dogs from ancient Mesopotamia. Being in the Neapolitan Mastiffs, it's brought me to this vision that I have doing research on that particular breed. It's brought me into it. So I've been working with that particular breed to work towards this American Molossus, and I've used some of the work of other breeders that have gotten away from the standards in those breeds that are very similar into what I'm trying to do. A lot of thought went into creating this breed. One thing obviously is health. Then you got to go to construction, temperament, function, what is the purpose of the dog, and all these thoughts have gone into my head. It's something that I've had envisioned for many years, breeding multiple breeds for the past 20 years has given me the experience. Having conversations with many good breeders has given me a lot of knowledge and a lot of input into what I'm planning on doing. And I definitely am going through the process. It isn't going to be a one-time thing. This is looking at dogs for function, for their look, for their temperament, movement. All that stuff has gone into it. Well, because a lot of years have already gone into this, standard has already been written and adopted. So the papers are there, the standard is there, and I'm really close. I have some of the stock already here. I plan on having, hopefully within 6 months to the next year, I plan on having the first American Molossus dogs on the ground. So people can actually see them, see the temperament, and see this. Now obviously keep in mind that there still will be a process, but this will be the first generation of the American Molossus, and I'll tell you what, I'm so excited, I'm so pumped to be able to share this dream of mine with the public. I'm really excited about it. And just like any new breed, when you look at them, you want to build on them. You want to continually improve and get to ultimately producing consistent type, look, and health of what I've envisioned. So I would say that the first American Molossus will be here 6 months to a year. The one thing I want to say about creating a new breed is there's a lot of risk. I understand that. There's going to be people that see the purebred specimens and all the work that I've put into my Neapolitan Mastiffs and the other breeds that I've incorporated and say, man, you're ruining good stock, good bloodlines, good dogs. And actually, I would disagree. I really think that I'm building on a lot of work for myself that's put in passion, hard time, sweat and tears into making a purebred. And anybody before me that's done this knows what goes into it. So I'm going to do the same thing in creating this new breed. A lot of blood, sweat and tears, passion, love. My family's behind it. There's several people that are breeders that are behind it. And it's going to be a success. I will not let it not be a success. I'm very passionate in what I do. And I know that this breed, this new breed, is going to be a huge success. And it isn't about the money. It's about the love and passion of what I have that's going into this breed.